Next problem, maximization of z is equal to 8000 x1 plus 7000 x2 subjected to the constraints 3x1 plus x2 plus 66 is less than equal to 66, x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 45, x1 is less than equal to 20, x2 is less than equal to 40. This is also maximization type of problem. So now we will take constraints as equation at the first stage. First constraint I will take, that is this constraint, 3x1 plus x2 is equal to 66. Right. Now put x1 is equal to 0. Put x1 is equal to 0. So x2 is equal to 66. x1 equal to 0, x2 is equal to 66. Put x2 is equal to 0. Put x2 is equal to 0, x1 is equal to 22. This is one line. 3 2 6, that is 322. 22 into 3 is 66. Right. So, first constraint. Next, second constraint I will take. x1 plus x2 is equal to 45. Put x1 equal to 0. x2 equal to 45. Put x2 is equal to 0, x1 is equal to 45. So this is second line. Then we'll go for third constraint. So it is directly x1 is equal to 20. Vertical line will get from this. Fourth constraint, x2 is equal to 40. Horizontal line will get from this. These are the four lines we have to draw on graph. By using graph, now we'll take the graph and then we'll draw lines. First, we have to draw maximum from the line 66 is highest. So, we were having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Right, 4 unit you can take, 1 unit is equal to 4 you can take. So we'll take 4 maximum is 66. So we will get 66 in the range. Then here also we will take 4 only. 4 x2 maximum is 45. x2 maximum is 45. We will take it as 66 is maximum, so we'll take 66. So on either side I have taken lines. Now what I will do, we'll take first line, check the first line. First line is having, put x1 equal to 0, x2 is 66, maximum x2 is 66. x1 is 22, first line. Second line, x1 is 45, x2 is 45. Third line, x1 equal to 20 as a vertical line, x2 equal to 40 as a horizontal line. So these are the four. First we'll go for x2 equal to 66, x1 equal to 22. This is the x1, this is x2. x1 equal to 22. We'll get here 22. x1 is equal to 22. x2 is equal to 66. Here we will get 66. Right. Now we will draw a line by joining these two. So both points should intersect. The thin line you have to draw. And you have to give arrow mark. to give error mark near to the origin because it is also less than equal to sign. And second line is 45 45, so 44 is here, 45, so we'll get 45 here, and here also we'll get 45. So we'll join these two lines. Extending on either side to give the arrow mark. It is also less than equal to sign. Then third line is x1 is equal to 20. So parallel to this x1 I will take x1 equal to 20. Slowly I will move. Right. We'll draw x1 equal to x2 equal to 40, x1 equal to 20 is there. So x1 I have to take in vertical direction. So we'll draw x1 equal to 20. And give arrow mark near to origin. Then x2 is equal to 40. Parallel to this, I have to take if you have graph, it is very easy to draw. And give the arrow marks near to the origin because all are having less than equal to sign. Now from this you have to check the feasible region. How to check the feasible region? Now you can consider any region. If you take this region, in this region this is indicating near at the origin. Here one more line away from the origin, here one more line away from the origin. Because of that, this region will not be considered. Now you can check this. This is away from the origin. This is inside the origin. This is inside. One line is away from the origin. If one line is away from the origin, that region will not be considered. You can take any. This region, but this region is away from the origin. So we'll take this region. This line is indicating inside. This line is indicating inside. This line is indicating inside. This line is also indicating. Four lines are intersecting in this region. Because of that, this region is considered as feasible region. And always in max object, the region you will get near to the origin. So this line is here, only this part. Right. Now we have got corners. So first corner, second corner, third corner, fourth corner, fifth corner, sixth corner. Six corner I have got. So we'll mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For all these six corners, we have to find Z value. Now, we have considered this as a first corner. For first corner, I will check. Corner 1, x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 0. So max of z is equal to 0. No need to calculate. For first corner, x1 and x2 are zeros. Because of that, you can write directly z is equal to 0. Now we'll go for corner 2. This is your corner 2. For corner 2, x1 is 0, but x2 is equal to 40. X1 is equal to 0, x2 equal to 40. Put the value of x1 and x2 in z. 3x1, 8000x1, 7000x2. So if you put value of x2 equal to 40, x1 equal to 0, you will get So that is 7000 multiplied by 40. 280,000 will get from the corner to Z, because x1 is 0 from corner 3. What is value of x1 is equal to, this is corner 3, and you have to find the value of x1 parallel to this x2 line. I will take, you will get around 4. X1 is equal to 4, x2 is equal to 40. Put the value in max of z. So z is equal to 8000 into 4 plus 7000 into 40. So we'll get z is equal to 312,000 from the corner 3. Now we'll go for corner 4. So what is x1 equal to and x2 equal to? This is the corner 4. From corner 4, you will get x1 as 10.5 will take, x2 as parallel to this, I have to take around 34. I am taking exact value. So put the value of x1 and x2, 8000 into 10.5 plus 7000 into 34.5. We will get z is equal to 325,000. From corner 4. Then corner 5, x1 is equal to, will have the value, this is the corner 5, that is 20. X2 is equal to 0. Put the value, x1 is 0 into 20. Sorry, x1 is 20 into 8000 plus 0. So z is equal to 160,000. So finally we'll get max of z is equal to maximum from all these corners 325,000. Max of z is equal to x1 is equal to 10.5, x2 is equal to 34.5 from the problem. You can check. Right, this is the exact answer you will get from the problem. I will go for next problem. Max of z is equal to 3000 x1 plus 2000 x2 subjected to the constraint x1 plus 2x2 is less than equal to 6. Two x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 8. X2 is less than equal to 2. So this is the problem. And x2 minus x1 is less than equal to 1. Four constraints we are having. So first constraint I will take, x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 6. Put x1 equal to 0. X2 is equal to 3. 2 into 3. Put x2 equal to 0. Find x1 equal to, x2 equal to 0, x1 equal to 6. So this is the first line. Second constraint, 2x1 plus x2 is equal to 8. Put x1 equal to 0. X1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 8. Put x2 equal to 0, x1 equal to 4. This is second line. Third constraint, x2 is equal to 2. Directly we will get one horizontal line. Next, fourth constraint, x2 minus x1 is equal to 1. Put x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 1. Put x2 equal to 0, x1 equal to minus 1. So these are the four lines we will get. These lines we will draw on graph. So we will consider here 1 is to 1 scale and we will give 1, 2, 3 only directly. Maximum 8 is there. On both sides will take same. So vertical is x2, horizontal is x1. Now we will mark first line, that is x2 equal to 3, that is x2 equal to 3, right, x2 equal to 3, x1 equal to 6. Now we will draw a line for this. Right, and we will give arrow mark because of less than equal to sign. Arrow mark should be near to the origin. Second line is x1 is equal to 4, x1 equal to 4, x2 is equal to 8. So we will draw one more line here. We will draw one more line. With thin line I will draw. We will be extending on either side to give arrow mark. Because of less than equal to sign, arrow mark should be near to the origin. Please remember, always less than equal to sign in the constraint means the arrow mark for those, for that line, particular line, you have to give arrow mark near to the origin. If it is greater than equal to sign, the arrow mark will be given away from the origin. Keep that in mind. Next one, x2 is equal to 2. So x2 is equal to 2, we will draw one line parallel to this x1. I will draw a line x2 equal to 2. And I will give arrow mark for this near to the origin. This is first, this is second, this is third. Last fourth one. Minus 1 is there, x1 is equal to minus 1. So I have to take either side, x1 is equal to minus 1. Right. X1 is equal to minus 1, x2 is equal to 1. X2 is equal to 1. So here we will get a line. X1 equal to minus 1, X2 equal to 1. The line will draw by joining these two points. And will give arrow mark near to the origin. This is what we got. Now we'll check a feasible region. Now you can check any of the region. First, if you take this region, for this line it is inside. This is away. This is away. This region will not be considered. You can take this region. This is inside. This is away. This is away. If you take this region, this is inside. This is away. For this, this is inside. This is inside. But this is away. So finally, this region is inside. This region is inside. This is inside. This is inside. These four lines will intersect on the same place. So because of that, we will consider this as a region. Now, how many corners we will get here? Corner number 1, कॉर्नर नंबर टू, कॉर्नर नंबर थ्री, कॉर्नर नंबर फोर, कॉर्नर फाइव, कॉर्नर सिक्स. सिक्स कॉर्नर वी गॉट. फॉर ऑल दिस सिक्स कॉर्नर वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट मैक्स ऑफ जेड. सो दिस सिक्स कॉर्नर वी गॉट. फॉर दिस सिक्स कॉर्नर वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट मैक्स ऑफ जेड. नाउ विल टेक कॉर्नर वन. What is x1 equal to? x2 equal to 0. For first corner, x1, x2 equal to 0. So, z is equal to 3000 x1, 2000 x2. So, z is equal to 0 because x1 and x2 are 0. Next, we'll go for corner 2. You have to calculate for this. Corner 2, x1 is 0, x2 is equal to 1. X1 is equal to 0, X2 equal to 1. Then Z is equal to 3000 X1 equal to 0 plus 2000 into 1. So Z is equal to 2000. Right. Next we'll go for corner 3. This is corner 3. For this corner 3 we have to calculate x1. We have x2 value. We will calculate x1 around how much we will get. We'll check. It is around 1 only. So we'll get x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 2. For this corner, x2 is equal to 2, x1 is equal to 1. And find the value z 3000 into 1 plus 2000 into 2. So z is equal to 3000 plus 4000, 7000. Next from corner 4. So this is corner 4. For this corner 4, once again we have to check the value of x1. Already we have x2 value. Only we have to calculate x1 value. It is around 2. X1 equal to 2. X2 equal to 2. So Z is equal to 3000 into 2 plus 2000 into 2. So Z is equal to 6000 plus 4000, 10000. Next from corner 5. This is corner 5. For this corner 5, we have to calculate X1 and X2. This is around 3.5 will take. X1 is 3.5. And this is around 1.5. So X1 is equal to 3.5. X2 is equal to 1.5. So Z is equal to 3000 into 3.5 plus 2000 into 1.5. So Z is equal to, we'll calculate 3000 into 3.5 plus 10500 plus 3000. 13,500. Next last corner, corner 6. So this is a corner 6. For this, x1 is equal to 4, x2 is equal to 0. So z equal to 3000 into 4 plus 2000 into 0. So we'll get z is equal to 12,000. So max of z is corner 5. So answer is max of z is equal to 13,500. For that x1 is equal to 3.5, x2 is equal to 1.5. This is how you have to solve. Approximate value have taken because of unavailability of the graph. So you can calculate with the graph, you will get the exact value. Thank you.